presence was urgently required. A gravely ill man was waiting for me in a village 10 miles distant. The girl appeared in the gateway, alone, waving a lantern, of course. Distracted, tormented, I kicked at the rickety door of a pigsty unused for many years. The lock gave, and the door swung back and forth on its hinges. Warm air, and solid, steaming bodies. Help him, I said, and right away the willing girl ran up to him. But no sooner has she reached him than the groom throws his arms around her and thrusts his face against hers. She screams and runs to me. There are the red marks of 2 rows of teeth on the girl's cheek. You animal! I scream in my rage. Do you want a taste of my whip? Myself, I'm talking to a stranger that I don't know where he comes from. I can make no sense of their confused reports. The air in the sick man's room is barely breathable. The neglected stove is smoking out. The lad pulls himself up in his bed. Doctor, let me die. Pick up a pair of pincers, and unimpressed by the screams of the family, but contemplating the patient, I lay my head against the chest of the boy, who shivers from the touch of my wet beard. Whistling softly. the length and thickness of my little finger, roseate and also coated with blood, writhing against the inside of the wound, with little white heads and many, many little legs. Poor boy, it's not going to be possible to help you. I found your great wound! That flower in your side is gonna finish you! Apparently you're happy. Now what should we going about my job?
Will you save me?
The boy whimpers, dazzled by the life in his wound. That's the way people are in this parish, always demanding the impossible from their doctor. They have lost their old faith. The priest sits around at home, ripping up his altar garments, one after another, but the doctor is expected to perform miracles with his delicate surgeon's fingers! Whatever. I'll see what I can do. What better thing is there for me, old country doctor that I am? And here they come, the family and the village elders, and they start to undress me. The school choir with the teacher at the front stands outside the house and sings. Cover the face of the moon. I am lying in the warm bedclothes. The horse's head sway shadowily in the open windows. You know, I hear a voice in my ear. I have very little faith in you. Instead of helping, you meant free with my deathbed.
I came into the world with a lovely wound.
Accept the word of honor of an official doctor. The horses were still standing faithfully in their places. I quickly managed to grab my clothes, fur coat and bag. I jumped onto the horse, the carriage careering around behind, and the fur dragging across the snow at the end. I said,
rejoice, you patients. The doctor has laid down with you in your bed.
The doctor has laid down with you in your bed. The nasty groom is rampaging through my house. Rosa is his victim. Naked, exposed to the frost of this most miserable epoch.
I've been swindled! Swindled! The misleading!